Christ's mercy land.
A reign of salvation and power.
Christ's mercy land.
A reign of salvation and power.
My name is Yamu Timothy. This is my son. It's my younger sister. I'm from Delta State here. My testimony goes like this because of time. 2005, I'm passing a lot of stress, like sickness, hardship, different things. But to God be the glory, the great surprise is that once I'm about to seek, if I don't have one error, I'm not going to seek. But once I have a little money, like 20,000, the sickness will come. Then if I have 5,000, I won't seek. But from 20,000 above, I will fail into sickness. From 2005 to 2015, I'm be suffering for it. There was a friend of mine, she's a lady. I don't know how I used to get a Mercyland bagel. She now gave it to me.
The wristband?
Yeah, wristband.
Okay.
She now gave it to me. I said, well, I'll try it because no hospital. I only treat malaria, typhoid. And once that 20,000 is gone, I will find. So the great surprise to me is that my lady friend, she used to encourage me. So I should go to Christ Mercy Land. And since I'm still using the rich bangle, I said, okay, no problem. Which I went. Then 2015, first Sunday, November. By then, we are still in Jakpa Road. Then the man of God came out, our senior prophet, Jeremiah Motofofin. He said that, anywhere that is paining you, I won't touch anybody, but go and get water. That's okay. And I just went out. I bought one can of water, ever water. It's okay. Anywhere that is paining your body, pour the water on your hand, use it to rub anywhere at all. That's okay. Now you say today I don't hear. And before I left home that moment, I always spoke. I said, God, as I'm going to this Christ Mercy Land, my dross is finished from hospital. Which, as I'm using the water to rub all over my body, I knew that something left me in that moment.
Power!
From that 2015 till now, I will go to hospital again.
Hey! Hey!
Then, this my little boy here, one faithful morning, I left there in the parlor when they are watching cartoon. You know, children are normally watching cartoon. I just left there in the parlor. Then I went to my bedroom. That very early, I wanted to come out, but the body not direct me to come at that moment. So I just slept off again. Then the senior to this one, with this very one, with the other one, both of them, I just came to my room. I said, what is the problem? To great surprise to me that this one, he cannot talk. I not knew anybody for the house. And the body is cold. It's just like they keep it in the fridge till they break. Let me put it that way. Now I say, when I go carry these people for fridge for night, they said no. Then what is the problem? And take off the clothes that I used to pass the night. I bait him. Then I bring it out again. He can't cry. He can't even see anybody against him. I said, God. And that very day, to God who made me, I don't have anything. I said, okay, if you said that, let us took this boy to hospital now. Where am I going to start with? So my wife said, don't worry. Any I be, your grown must jump. I said, okay, no problem. Then immediately, I said, okay, let us go to any nearby hospital. Our senior prophet Jeremiah for fear motor, his voice now came. Where are you going for hospital? You already, doctor is with you.
Hey.
I And I, for my mind, and I say, I don't have any doctor friend or relation. The voice speak again, yeah, with your doctor. Now I reply, which of the doctor? He say, your rich bango is your doctor right now.
Power! Mm.
I said, what am I going to do with the rich bago? It's okay. I should wear the shag. I said, I should wear the dice. Or he said, yes. I said, boy, come. I bring the hand. By then, he's weak. He can't talk. I wear in the rich bago. The minute I wear in the rich bago, he now say, daddy. I
said, hey! Power! You did not hear him. I said, you did not hear him. You are still sitting like that. You did not hear him. Oh my God. The God of Prophet Jeremiah will speak to you.
Immediately, she called me. He called me daddy. And I said, good. The thing is working now. And I call his senior ones. I say, Morgan, a miracle. You push, you come. Who is this? Say, hey, Morgan. Who is this? Say, miracle. I say, good. It don't work.
It has then, happened.
Then, in fact, there's no hospital again. Nothing. That is why my son healed.
Just like that. So simple like that. Ha!
This my younger sister here. Yeah? When she took in, I don't knew that the pregnancy is due. There was a night I slept. A man of God, the same prophet Jeremiah, almost of faith, came to me with voice. He said, one young lady, she's lying down in the hospital. Come and take a look of her. Which I followed him. When I got there, she's already in theater. And I said, what is the meaning of this? Say they want to operate her. If cannot take her, she will go. The child will go. I say, God forbid. I ask man of God, okay, what am I going to do now? In fact, I got confused that moment. It's okay, I should pray for her. Just like that, but I'm not a prophet. Now he said, don't worry, go and pray for her. I said, okay, no problem. Which the next day morning, as I wake up, it's a dream. I say, what? What kind of a dream is this? The next morning, I pick phone, I call her. Look at the dream I had last night to pray. I will still pray for you. He said, okay, no problem. Then about 3 weeks later again, the same about 3 a.m. midnight, the same man of God took me again. Said, look at your sister. This is the final day. She will deliver, but pray for her. Immediately I woke up, I start praying. Immediately I dropped. I end up the prayer, my phone now ring. Her husband. I said, what is the problem? I'm even hearing people's voice. I said, don't worry. My God of Jeremiah, for fear or motor, he has done it. Don't worry yourself. I said, okay, this is what the man of God told me. I will do it. I said, just lay your hand on her head. I will pray for you through my phone.
Hey!
Which I did that moment. So I now slept off again. About 4 a.m., man of God came again. Say, are you sleeping? I said, I'm tired now. He said, no, you won't tired though. Say, wake up. And I wake up again. It's okay. What am I going to do this time, man of God? He said, do you have your sister poster around you? I say, yes, sir. I said, but for me to find that picture this night, it will take time because I have a lot of pictures. He said, don't worry. To God be the glory. As I just went to my cupboard, this poster is the first poster I saw there.
Power! Is that the picture of your sister?
Yes, that is the picture.
Uh-huh.
So, I said, and I asked him again, what am I going to do with the picture? He said, I should put my rich bangle and praise it on top. Which I did. I now pray with her finish. Then I now hold the bishop, put it in my shirt, put the rich bag on my shirt. I slept off again. Then immediately I slept again. The man of God came again, don't sleep. Oh. I said, but I'm tired now. I said, okay, no problem. I said, okay, what am I going to do this time? He said, I should took the rich bag to give to her the next day morning. I will see what the Lord will do. I said, okay, no problem. Which the next morning I did. Immediately I left there, she put on a baby bathing gown.
Hey.
Power!
Hey! Somebody shout hallelujah! So that is how she gave birth to a bouncing baby girl.
Yes, yes. This is the rich bag.
Our sister, let me ask you. When you were in labor, you were in labor for like how long when you were not able to deliver this baby?
I've due for more than 1 month. So before the prophecy came, and my brother told me that I should not worry, I will deliver successfully. Since Prophet Jeremiah Mutu Fofoe will do it for me. So the night the attack came, that was the day I fell into labor. So my brother told me I should not worry. He prayed with me on phone. Then the next day morning he came. I was rushed to the hospital. Then he handled this bangle with me and he used this bangle to pray with me.
But before then, you were in the theater.
Yes.
Doctor said it's through oppression.
Yeah, will operate me. Then I will go there. The baby will stay.
Yeah? That you will go and the baby will stay.
Yes.
That is evil report.
So my brother prayed with me with the wristband and he handled this wristband into my hand. As soon as he left, I deliver successfully.
You deliver successfully. No more oppression. Ah! And that is the baby girl. Oh my God. God has done great and marvelous things in the life of this family.
You know, life is full of challenges. But my own is that once you put your trust in God, I believe he won't disappoint you.
The God of our papa never disappoints. And that God is right here now. I said, this God will never disappoint you in the name of Jesus.
Gloire à l'Éternel. Nous venons de suivre le merveilleux témoignage de ce frère qui est venu avec sa petite sœur pour donner vraiment gloire au Dieu du prophète Jérémie Omoto Fofoe. Il a commencé à expliquer que quand il a de l'argent, c'est en ce moment que la maladie arrive. Et c'est quand il a de l'argent jusqu'à 20 000 naira, 30 000 naira, qu'il devient toujours malade. Mais un jour, il était venu ici, dans un programme qu'on avait eu avec le prophète, et le prophète avait prié dans l'eau pour lui. Le prophète avait prié dans l'eau pour tout le monde, on le sait bien. Mais lui, il avait utilisé uniquement pour ce qui le gêne. Parce que c'est quand il a de l'argent qu'il est toujours malade. Quand il n'a pas d'argent, il est toujours vraiment très sain. Et ainsi, comme le prophète avait prié pour tout le monde, et que lui avait pris ça pour son sujet, il a été à la maison et il a vu que les maladies qui arrivent lorsqu'il a de l'argent avaient cessé. Non seulement ça, il avait eu un bracelet ouin dans sa main. Et le bracelet ouin dans sa main l'a beaucoup sauvé de tous les dangers qui l'arrivaient. Sa petite sœur aussi qui avait une grossesse prolongée. Et elle ne pouvait pas aussi enceinter après un an. Et c'est ainsi que le même bracelet qu'il utilisait et qu'il le délivrait, sa petite sœur a utilisé le bracelet et l'a délivré comme une femme hébreuse. Et c'est pourquoi ils sont ici aujourd'hui, pour remercier le Dieu Tout-Puissant de tout ce que Dieu a fait dans leur vie. Applaudissons le Seigneur pour tout ça.
Our brother, we celebrate with you for what the Lord has done in your life. Let it be permanent in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.